Here, we are going to learn about one of the simplest coordinate frames in observational astronomy. And as any observation process involves, it has two components, the observer, which you can see here, and the observed, which will be presented to the observer on a screen. And that screen is going to be a sphere, at the center of which the observer stands. So everything in the universe, the stars, galaxies, planets, nebulae, everything would be projected onto the screen so the observer can see them. This is called as the celestial sphere, and we'll be representing it with this circle. Now, at no point of time, the observer can see the whole celestial sphere. He or she can see only half of it, and that is limited by the horizon. In the best possible conditions, everything above the horizon will be seen, but nothing below the horizon will be observable. Then we are going to establish a few points. The first point is called zenith. It's right above the observer on the celestial sphere. And then let's establish north. Maybe we know how to find north using a pole star, or maybe we have a GPS or a compass, or we ask the next person. And once we know north, we can also put down where is south, west, and east. Then we are going to look at a star. But as you know, we are not going to look at a star directly, but we are going to look at the projection of that star on our screen. So here is the projection of the star, okay, as it appears on the celestial sphere. And on this sphere, we are going to draw an arc, which will start at the zenith, pass through the star, and we will continue that till it meets the horizon. So this is the arc over here, and this arc is going to subtend an angle. So this angle will be measured from the horizon to the star. So this angle, called as the altitude, represents how far up the star is in the sky. But that alone is not sufficient to know the position of the star, because there are going to be many other celestial objects which are at the same height. For example, everything on this circle will have the same angle of altitude. And therefore, to nail it down, we need something more. So let us have another angle here, which will be measured from the north in the eastward direction till we hit this plane. This is called as the azimuthal angle. Let us label it. And these two angles together will be able to specify, pinpoint anything in the sky. So this is the local coordinate frame, and it uses two angles. Azimuth, angle measured from north towards east till we hit the plane of the star, and then we go up through the angle of altitude and we see the image of the star. Let's recap the whole thing, but this time in color. So we start with the observer, who is surrounded by the celestial sphere, which is divided into two halves by the horizon. Only the upper half is seen. In the upper half, we have the highest point, called as the zenith, and the north point is established, from which east, west, and south can be figured out. And we start observing a star. To do that, we draw an arc passing through the zenith, the star, till it meets the horizon. And then we measure the angle of altitude, which represents how far up the sky is the star. And then we measured another angle to pin it down, which is measured from north in the easterly direction till we hit the plane of the angle of altitude. This is called as the azimuthal angle. So together, azimuth and altitude can pinpoint any location in the sky. This is the local coordinate frame.